Hey guys, I'm Sugar Kush, and this is Cinnabrolls.
Yeah?
Cinnabrolls.
Okay.
Short nigga but my dick tall. What a treasure bitch dog. Only thug nigga damn with the pitchfork. Dirty fan bitches wanna suck my dick off. Papa's any for a penny, get the hit floor. Run up in the shit raw. I got a girl, I ain't never come to fucking condoms. If she caught me, then that bitch, I'd be pissed off. Shabba, 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 shabba.
I'm SugarKush, and this is Cinnablunts.
She got it right.
I know, I got it right first time. And this is our show. What we do on this show is people. Hey, how you doing? I'm over here. Yeah. You ask us questions. You send us topics. We answer them the best way we can. And advice, same way, best way we can. Topics. We'll give you our true opinion about it, whether you like it or not. Yeah. You can follow me at CG Webster, that's one word, 92. And you can follow, you can find Kira at, Kira, what are you doing?
Oh, I was quoting you.
At on Facebook.
At Kira Loving Me Jackson. Sorry, I don't have a Twitter. You can kick me. My kick name is True_Pleasure.
Of course. And so we're going to start talking about, we're going to have a couple of questions. Again, if you send us questions, send it to the SK and CB show at, oh no. The SK and CB show, the link is going to be below, don't worry. The SK and CB show. 89@gmail.com. That way you stay anonymous and we don't care who you are. You know, we just want to ask these questions. You know, Thomasville ain't bustin' big, so we know everybody. Just saying.
Hopefully we get more people from Thomasville because I hate for my cousin to send me a question.
I hope we get more people out of Thomasville. But that's my opinion.
I said I mean.
Kira. Okay, so Kira, this is what we do. We're going to ask you these questions in like 20 seconds per person. Okay. So, Kira, you going to have your phone and use the timer?
Timer? Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Do it in seconds, please. Because that's, I'm going to go first. You know, I like to talk.
Time.
Okay, ready? So, we're going to do it in 20 seconds for me.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Okay.
There you go.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right, this from someone I don't know who they are. Is it a wise decision to break the law to save a loved one? In my opinion, no, because you're breaking the law, so chances are you're gonna wind up with that person in jail. I would say the best thing to do. That was not 20 seconds.
Yes, it was.
Bump that 20 seconds. Anyway, we're only going to ask the questions. I would say do it from the legal stance. Try to help your friend get a lawyer or get some legal advice. See what you can do. Save up some money so you can bail them out. You know, that's what I would do. What would you do, Kira?
Me personally, I don't believe in going to jail for anybody else.
Damn right.
So, I would suggest, you know, give them that good I love you speech before they leave. You know, I love you. I will be there for you. You know, write me if you need me. You know, I do my best I can to help you out, you know. But as far as lying, to help a loved one, no. I won't. It depends. Nah. See, if. Nah, I just wanna do it. Don't do it. It's a bad thing.
That's where we both agree on. Don't do it, okay? Next question. Here you go.
Okay. How do you let go of someone that you know is not good for you? How you let go of a person you know is not good for you? Well, I guess you can start off with little steps, you know. Like, y'all talk on the phone, text, like, yeah, if you cut that out, maybe. You know, try not to see this person, you know, give them that type of attention that you used to give them, you know. If you willing to be their friend, you know, that's fine. You can let them know that, you know, I can always be your friend, but as far as us getting together, you know, it's not going to work. And focus on, find something else to take your attention off that person. Usually another body would definitely do that. I'm not suggesting it, though.
Girl, don't. Mm-mm.
Like, because there's some arts and people. Crafts,
now, you know, some something. People, they go from one body to another body to another body, just getting over, trying to get over that one ex. Like,
okay,
you
well,
don't do
like
that.
This.
Don't do that.
How about this? You know, they tell you to go the spiritual way. You know, go to church, pray about it. You know, become one with the Lord. I'm not gonna tell you that because everybody don't do that. I will say this: sex is usually the thing that keep you with somebody you don't need to be with. So, buy a toy. Usually does.
Okay, for me, I say get over the person on your time when you want to. Don't get over the person because everybody's telling you to get over. Which, when if you have really good friends, they're going to tell you that person's a dog. Fuck that fuck boy. Fuck that nigga. Forget him. But at the same time, people are stubborn. People are stubborn. Really stubborn. And they ain't going to listen to. They won't listen to your friends. You're going to listen to your friends. But at the same time, you're not going to listen to your friends. So, it'd be best to do it on your own terms and on your own time. Because when you finally do it on your own time, it don't matter if it takes a couple months to maybe a year for some people. Not for everybody. But for some people, it might take a year. But it's still, let you know, you need to get off and get away from that person on your own time. Because it'd be better that way than feeling like you have to get away from that person. Because if you feel like you have to get away from that person, then chances are you're going to run right back to that person. So, just do you. Have a good time. Delete his phone number or her phone number. Don't text him. Don't call him. Don't even delete him on Facebook, Twitter, everything. Because if you see him or if you see their number, like,
yeah, don't.
If you see their number, you see their face, you want to call him. You want to text him. Don't do it. For a couple of months, try your best not to acknowledge him at all. And if they try to come back to you, do that by Felicia and keep it moving.
You know, I can give you a simpler way how to get over somebody that's not good for you. Have you seen Tyler Perry movie Temptation? If not, I suggest you watch. Teach you a lot. Mostly it scared me not to fall for temptation because I don't want AIDS.
That might not be the concept of the thing.
Carrie, you're just get to the point.
I don't know. Just don't talk to them. I don't know. I can't say get over it on your own time because some people, they have it in their mindset. They have it set up where it take them a lifetime to get over that one
well,
person.
Well, that's okay then. Why shouldn't it? Why
no, it's not okay. Not if they're trying to get over the person that they know they don't need to be with. Then, you know, ain't nothing but bad, negative things coming from in the first place. Then you can't necessarily be like, okay, do it on your own time.
Yeah.
Because, no, because their own time is never going to come. That's what I'm saying.
Why? You can't tell somebody that it will come.
You can't tell somebody that's trying to get over somebody to, you know, do it on your own time because that's for them. They're saying, well, you know, it's okay for us to still do this right now. You know,
oh, no,
I'm not ready.
No, no.
And then 5 years from now, they're still gonna be saying the same thing. Well, you know, I'm not ready to let them go.
Oh,
yet.
No,
you know, my own
no.
time. This is my own
okay,
time.
Okay, I understand what you're saying. Let me tell you right now. When I say do it on your own time, I mean slowly but surely, like what Kira was saying. Cut them off inch by inch by inch by centimeter to millimeter to feet. You know, no text message, no calling, no checking on social media, seeing what they're doing. Like, you do it little by little by little by little. Because while you're doing that, there's other people around you that want to talk to you and stuff like that. So while you're doing it on your own time, you also cutting them off. Don't do it on your own time and not do nothing about it. Because if you don't do nothing about it, then that person will easily come back and say, hey, what's up, man? What you doing? You know, like, no. You do that by Felicia. Next question. Okay. What do you do when a friend tells you something, you mention it to someone else, and your friend comes back and confronts you about it? Child, back. Like, when I have two mutual friends that I know are talking about each other, I usually try my best to stay out of it. That's the best way to go. Don't try to help nobody. If you know your homegirl getting cheated on by your homeboy, and you can't, I'm sorry, but sometimes you might have to let nature happen. You just have to say, watch out. You can say, watch out, but that's all you gotta do. You don't say, such and such is cheating on you, but you need to watch your back. That's all you need to do. If you do more than that, then you're in too deep, because it could turn around and come back to you. That's why I say, when I talk to mutual friends and they ask me what a certain person say, I'm like, okay, I'm not going to tell you exactly what she said, but I'm going to tell you the gist of it. This is what she's saying. You know, this is how she feels. Okay? That way, it's no confusion. It's no he said, she said, me. Because when he said, she said, me, it gets confused. And then people get into drama. This is how drama is created. Over he said, she said, me. I don't do that.
Well, see, from experience,
I had friends something like that, trying to help a friend out.
It wasn't even trying to help a friend out. It was with me knowing somebody or being friends with this person, and people knowing that I'm close to this person, so they coming to me asking me questions about their personal business. With me being the type of person I am, I'm automatically hit you with that, oh, well, I don't know nothing about that. You know, you have to ask that person themselves, but I'd be like, you know, if that is true, you know, that's their business. Well, you know, some kind of way it got back told, girl, that I was talking about her and I was putting her business out there, and I was going to tell people, you know, her situation. So when she confronted me about it, I told her the truth. I told her what the person said to me, but I didn't give no name. And I told her what I said. And I didn't do nothing but be honest, because, see, you're not somebody that can control my life, therefore I ain't got to lie to you.
Exactly.
I'm always being upfront and honest with you.
Exactly.
Because, see, for one, I don't know you and you don't know me like that. So, you know, it's whatever. But I told her, and she didn't want to believe me. And she tried to fight me, but I felt it was real petty. So, I don't fight over petty stuff. But my main thing is, you know, you have some people that do you like that, but it's all about, you know, how you feel. It's all how your personal values, I guess. Because, see, me, I'm not going to fight over he say, she say, only because you never know what's true. Mm-hmm. And when somebody tell you something, like she says, best to keep it to yourself, or go to that person themselves and ask that person, mm-hmm, not to go pass it along to somebody else, and so they can pass it along, because that's just like the game telephone. Like, you tell, mm-hmm, something, somebody in their ear, and see what it's like when it gets to between
the
person.
By the time
we
get to the halfway point,
the whole story
is already different. Yeah.
And it's, no, they ain't gonna do nothing but cause unnecessary drama that didn't have to come in the first place.
Exactly.
So I say, just keep to yourself. Mm-hmm. And somebody come.
Don't help nobody.
Yeah. Don't. It's
don't
not
do it. It's not worth it.
Somebody come to you, then you go to that person who they talk to you about, because that's the best way to keep drama down, and that's the best way to keep yourself out of it.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't gotta mention names. You ain't gotta drop names. No need for that. Just be like, you know, certain fairy in the air told me this right here, you know, I had to come ask you about it. So that's the adult thing to do. Everybody will call themselves an adult. Everybody want to claim grown, so it's about time to start acting like it.
Okay. All right, next question. There you go.
Why is it so hard for parents to
understand? Brown one.
Okay, we don't.
No, we still have that one. Child,
tripping. How will we know? How will we know what the real world consists of?
That's for you, freshman 18, right there. You know, that's the freshman's 18.
There's some answer to that question.
You won't
until you live it. you know, your parents always telling you, know, oh, this is going to be hard. This is gonna
Is it good?
I forgot who it was.
You said your parents are working hard and shit.
Okay. So, okay, you grow up and your parents always telling you, you know, this right here don't come free, this don't come free, you gotta work for this and you gotta work for that, you know. When you out there on your own, it's not gonna be easy, it's gonna be this hard. You know, they ain't lying to you. They's being very, very honest with you. At least when they tell you that much. And it's very hard, but you'll never know what it consists of because everybody's different, everybody have different struggles. It's all about how you work through it, your dedication, your commitment to whatever it is you're trying to do or you want to do to, you know, work your way through life. Some people it's easy, some people it's very hard. Mm. It's up to you though. I mean, you decide how your life gonna be out there in the real world. You know, because it's all about the things you do.
Okay. For me, I would say, you don't know. You can't plan shit out. For me, my plan was going to Atlanta, graduating in Atlanta, and be done. Okay, so what was that? Okay, so for me, like I said, you can't plan nothing. You can't plan shit. Like, what I planned for me was to go to Atlanta, graduate, and be up in Atlanta and do my thing. Okay, life happens. Life will always happen to you. You know, you just got to prepare yourself for it, learn from your mistakes, and keep it moving. Because whether you give up now or you just give in to the, I guess, pressures of everybody else, the world is still going to keep turning. People still going to be making their money. I'm still going to be getting paid on Fridays. Okay? So the best thing you need to do is go to college, find yourself a job, try to balance both, if not one or the other, and pursue your dreams. Because I feel like we're in the era right now, they call it the virgin era, because so many people right now is doing their music. Like, they're not running to record labels to put their music out there. They're on SoundCloud. They're on Twitter. They're on mixtapes.com. They're everywhere. Like, they're not waiting to be picked up. They're moving constantly. And you got to do the same thing. You know, you can't just sit back and wait for opportunities to come to you. You got to go to your opportunities. You got to open that door. So, that's my question. That's my answer for you. You know, nothing is planned out. Just be ready for life when it hits you. Okay. You know, just good guidance right there. Last question. Why is it hard for parents to understand their kids? Kara? You got a lot of little ones, little sisters and brothers, so you could tell them.
Why is it hard for parents to understand their own kids? It's really not. They try to make it seem like they don't understand you. But I'm gonna put it like this. Your parents understand you 100%. You just don't agree with what they have to tell you. So that make you feel like they don't understand you, but when you sit back and you listen, you pay attention, they honestly reading you 100%. But because, you know, at a certain age or time period, you know, you start to smell yourself and you be like, oh, I hate you. You never understand anything I'm going through. You understand nothing I'm saying. Da da da. You know, it's not like that. They understand. They understand 100%. That's why they treat you the way they treat you. Now, you might get the parents that they're very lenient. You know, they don't care. You feel like, oh, my mama understand me 100%. No. That means your mama make the same mistakes you making right now, and she just don't kill.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the parents that you feel like don't understand you, they done been through it. They're just trying to teach you a lesson. They're trying to keep you from going through the things that they went through. You know, they want you to have a better life. So they say.
For me, my parents had me working when I was 16 years old. So everything that happens up till now, I bought myself. My truck, my clothes, my laptop, everything, my camera, everything that I have, I've been working and I got it. My phone bill, I got my stuff. And I think that's a good thing to have parents like that that's on to you because they've been through the same shit you've been through, even though you don't understand it right now. Once you get to the early 20s, mid-20s, you'll be like, dang, mom, like, you were right about this. Dang, dad, you was right about this situation. And y'all become friends. This is what happens. Like, when you're in your teens, like Kira said, you're feeling yourself, you smell yourself. You're going through high school, you're going through peer pressure and all this stuff. You're trying to fit in high school, middle school. So you're dealing with that attitude. So that attitude is going into home. You try to act big and bad while you're at the house. Mama ain't playing it. But we're done talking to parents, about parents, right?
Okay, we're done.
But yeah, like, I was done with mine.
Oh, we're done.
Okay. Well, hey guys, just hit us up at the link below. It's going to be the SKSCBshow89@gmail.com. We're doing a show every Tuesday, so just hit us up with questions and topics. Nothing foolish. Nothing crazy. Don't put nobody's name in the question. Because this is Thomas and I know everybody.
Well, you could. Because see,
don't do no nicknames either.
I'm nosy. So you can shoot me the names and I'm just be anonymous.
Kira, don't tell them that. Don't listen to her. Because you know you're going to have the ratchets doing it. Say, oh, my baby daddy.
You're going to call y'all ratchet. Put the name in there.
But.
At they Twitter name, so I know, but it's real.
Whatever. I'm Sugar Kush.
And I'm Cinnablunts.
And this is the Sugar Kush and Cinnablunts Show. Yeah.
Peace.